question about the work you have done, and especially can you talk about your mom?
Thank you. Good morning, Dr. Pavitra, and I wish you a happy Mother's Day, all of you. It's a pleasure and a privilege to be on your, you know, video this one today. And myself, I am Dr. Dasharath Ram Reddy. I am professor and the head of the Department of Orthopedic Yashoda Group of Hospital. Now it is almost 30 years of experience now. I initially worked at Nizam's, then I got trained in UK and the US and many European countries and Australia. For past 20 years, I am in Hyderabad with Yashoda Group. Basically, I am an orthopedic surgeon, special interest in complex trauma, and I am a reconstructive surgeon. And I am a sports medicine surgeon as well as the joint replacement and back surgeon. You name the surgery, I do it head to toe. That's it. I can say that. Wow. And you know, I don't want to much, you know, go into the detail further, because I want to dedicate and that whatever the time you have given, I want to answer the questions so that we don't waste much time. So I want
wonderful
to meet many people as possible during this brief period.
Yeah, but that's such a lovely introduction, because moms do get ready with your questions, especially.
I'm sorry, I forgot to tell about mom. Whatever I am today, it is just because of my mom. I lost my father when I was 1 year old. She brought me in a very hardship, and unfortunately, I lost her two and a half years back. That is 2016. In October, she passed away.
Oh my God.
And is a great lady in my life, and whatever I am, my day starts with her sweet memories and ends with her sweet memories. That's all I can say about my mom. Nothing more than that.
Wonderful, sir. Sir, here, you know, a lot of mothers, you know, especially during post-pregnancy, they give up on their career and they give up everything for the kids. Like your mom, how was her journey when she was raising you?
Can you repeat it? I could not hear much.
Yeah. So what I'm saying is, a lot of mothers give up on their life post they have kids, you know, they dedicate their entire life. They sacrifice their whole life only for kids. Was it the same case with your mom? How did she raise you guys?
You know, we are six actually. I am the last but one. Yeah. And, you know, like any, I call it as a united, you know, combined family it was. There were hardships and there was the good memories, bad memories, everything. And we had a great support from my maternal grandparents and my mother's brothers and all. Mm-hmm. So, and my mother's motto, I lost my father in a tragic accident. That time, 53 years now, 52 years. And that time, there was no, he died in a small remote place. There was no medical attention. And in fact, May 50 is a tragic day in our life, 1968. Mm-hmm. So, you know, motto was that I should become an orthopedic surgeon, because my father died of accident and there was no medical facility those days. So from the day one, when I joined school, she always used to tell, you should become a doctor, you should become a doctor. That idea has impregnated in my mind. I said that, okay, like that, I always thought that I should become doctor, number two doctor, number three doctor, nothing else.
Wonderful. So it's because your dad passed away with no access to medical facilities, and you being the youngest child, you were right from your childhood, you decided that you have to become a doctor so that you can save, like no other person should go through the similar situation.
Yes. I became, you know, anybody can do any operation. But what I do was there's a master in my complex trauma. That is, you know, run over. Somebody is, you know, run over by a vehicle where their limbs are completely crushed, like a bag of bones, or the muscles are crushed like a mince, and the nerves are injured and arteries are damaged. That's where my role is. I am the face. I don't say that it is completely my work. It's a team of doctors. I have a doctors like a plastic surgeon, vascular surgeon, and a neurosurgeon, general surgeon, and all. Depending on their necessity, I involve them. I lead the show and I do the work and with their help, and we try to give near normal limb to the patients or victims. That's where I stand now. That's where what I stand now. That in fact I am the very one of the very few surgeons in India who has this teamwork.
Wonderful, wonderful. So nice to know. So when your father passed away, what was your age, sir?
Exactly, it was 2.5 years.
Oh my God! And there were 6 children, and your mom single-handedly raised you all.
Yes, that is true.
Wow, that's such an inspiration. Nowadays, with 1 or 2 kids that we have, we actually find it very difficult to raise kids. And with having 6 kids and absolutely no support, your mom raised not just normal kids, but someone like you, who is an inspiration, who's saving many lives from tragedy. So, can you share what attributes in your mother as a child? You would have seen your mother go through difficult phases. Can you just share that story with us?
Yes. It was a farmer family. My father was a very well-known, very big contractor those days. He was the only person who studied graduation those days. Doing a graduation is like a PhD, not even PhD, more than that. So he is one of the very few academicians in those days in my place. So there's a place called Anapati in Rishodar district. So he was the whole and soul of all this business and all. Once he died, he died at the age of 32. And nobody knew what all the businesses he was doing. We don't know what he earned, how he earned, and where did he keep, and everything. So what happened, within 1 year, the whatever the earnings or whatever it may be, that got, siphoned or whatever it may be, partners, I don't blame. The situation was like that. So it was like, we were having a very lavish life. Within 1 year, the whole thing turned. And I went to school up to 7th standard without a footwear.
Oh my God.
Yeah, that was the situation. So luckily in 1974, my uncles, started, they settled well and they started supporting also. So again, the life has, we went back to the original situation, and again there was not much of hardship after I entered 8th standard. Till 7th standard we had a very, very tough time, and all this, my mother never lost her hope. She used to motivate us, but she was very tough lady. She was like a tigress, and we are all afraid. Even till the last date of her death, we were very much afraid of her. Like, she says that one thing, okay, you do this. I go, yes, mom, that's all, nothing else. It was not a dictatorship. It was, her, firmness in her discipline. That's what I mean. She inculcated the discipline. We should not be in the bed after 5 a.m. Even you sleep at 1 a.m. in the night, you have to get up in the bed. And she used to insist up to 10th standard early bed. After intermediate, once we entered the intermediate plus two, okay, now by sleeping early, you cannot finish the course. So she used to leave us, okay, you study as much as you can, but no excuse, you have to get up at 5 o'clock. So that is the thing that made us. So You eat, eat meat that she, the, it has become my, you know, natural clock. By 5 o'clock, wherever I am in the world, I get up at 5 o'clock of Indian Standard Time. That's the problem. I find the difficulty when I go out of country.
Wow. Yeah. So when you were 2 years old, you lost your dad, and because no one in the family was aware of what was happening, what your dad was doing.
They knew the business he was doing. They don't know like the, you know, financial management. They didn't know whom he has given the money. They don't know whom he owes the money, like that. So by 1 year, everything is became a white paper.
Right. I totally understand. So now in Million Moms, we are 100% focusing on, we're telling mothers only one thing, okay? No matter what you're doing, you may not be even working, that's okay. But you have to understand what is your family's financial condition. This is what we are repeatedly telling all mothers, because if we are unaware, if we are so busy taking care of kids and our day-to-day activities, if at all some circumstances arises, it will become really tough. We have to build back from complete bottom. The situation is really bad, really bad for any family. So what do you have to tell about this to other mothers, sir? What is your advice to people who are watching, especially with respect to finances?
Yes. Now, the situation, okay. Now, we can talk about before Corona, after Corona. Before, you know, it has turned the life of the person who was having a single meal per day to who is having the lavish meal. So everybody's life is turned out, and there is no rich, no poor, like that. Everybody is in the same platform. The corona has neutralized everything. It's normally, you know, what equalized everything. Before, whatever it may be, now we should have very, very careful in financial management. Before, somebody was earning 100 rupees by working 1 hour, now you have to work 3 hours to earn the same money. That means your income has come down and your hardship has increased. At the same time, you should have a financial independence like Western people. Unfortunately, I'm sorry, but I'm telling you this. This is not a, this is what my observation is. Even now, at least 70 to 80% of the Indian women, they depend on their husband for financial needs. This culture has to go. They should raise the head and live. They should have their financial independence. There are so many jobs available now. You don't need to go out and do work hard. You can sit at home, do the things by using your online business or computer or something. There are so many businesses. You sit at home and earn. Work from home. You don't need to go. So you can take care of your parents. You can take care of the small children. And at the same time, you can take up, you know, you can do your housework and everything. Same time, you don't need to undergo the stress of traveling outside. You are available all the time at home. Same time, the whatever 1 hour or 2 hour or 3 hour time that is available, you can use for earning. That's where you will become financially independent. One thing, it will compensate the loss, whatever we are getting post-corona scenario. That's what I personally feel.
Right. Sir, also from your personal experience, your mother has to raise 6 children after a very, very traumatic incident where she lost her biggest support. What was the attitude of your mother? How can mothers of today instill that attitude in the family so that they don't give up, but they have that spirit to overcome any kind of, obstacle that can happen in their lives?
Yes. Let me be very frank. I don't hide the fact she underwent a psychological depression for 1 year. She attempted, you know, like, I will end my life. You know, that's a common phenomena.
Mm-hmm.
Even people are imagine the place, no support and to tell, happy my grandmother and grandfather, there is no meaning for my life, I would like to end my life. So my grandmother, my mother's mother, she is another great lady in my life. She motivated, okay, you are, if you struggle, you are the only one who is going to struggle. If you end the life, you are putting your children to struggle or to undergo a very bad phase in their life. You take a call. That triggered my mother. My mother told me many a time, I told my mother that I would end my life. But your grandmother told me that if you die, imagine the future of your children. That blocked me, that stopped me taking any untoward incident, you know, in a hasty step or ending life or something like that.
Right.
Motivated me, that made me strong, and I lived for you people. That's what, the memory, you know, with the sweet memories, whatever she had with my father. And I'm sure that she would have ended her life had my grandmother was not there.
So we need some woman in our life to support others and help them see the light. It's
yes.
not, it's okay.
I will tell you, I will tell you, sorry to interrupt you. A woman knows a woman's mentality than a man. I personally feel that. So the greatest support any woman will get from another woman, not from men. That's what. Though I am a man, I am telling you honestly this opinion.
Right. So the story just shows something very beautiful. It's okay to go through phases of depression. It's okay to have those thoughts. But that doesn't mean that is the end of life. Even from that, the bottommost point of your life, if you decide to look for the future, if you have hope, if you think about others in the family and you step forward, you can come out of the worst situations. Is that right, sir?
Yeah, it's true. Yes, exactly, you're right. She looked back her children, motivated her to work hard and bring up the children. That's where we are now.
Right. So all our mothers are joining us. Harichandana is saying it's a very wonderful discussion. Atni Shetty, she's saying it's the most interesting chat on Mother's Day till now. And Harichandana also says it's the need of the hour to adapt to the situation faster. We can always sit down and keep worrying that, oh my God, things are going wrong. But the faster we adapt to the situation, the quicker we come out of it and start taking action, that is when we can step forward, no matter how bad a situation it is currently. Am I right, sir?
Yes. I will tell only one example. The people who doesn't have any support, living on there with the hand-to-mouth situation, having so many children, they are facing the world, they are facing the situation, and bringing up their children. When fortunately we are blessed, or we are more fortunate, more than millions of people ahead. So definitely we should be more stronger. The world should follow you. The only thing what you have to do is you have to be a trendsetter. And that will lighten so many lives, even without your knowledge. People look at you and follow your footsteps. They don't even tell you that that they followed you, or you don't even know that somebody is following you. But indirectly, you are helping the society that everybody will have hardships. You have to come out on your own. Because why I'm telling you on your own? Now, people don't have time to spend time with you. They don't have time for themselves. Then how can you expect they will spend time with you? And now most of the people are nuclear families. We don't have a Vasudhaika Kutumbam like some 20, 30 years back. So you have to be strong and you have to motivate yourself and on your own. You have to come up on your own. That's what I personally feel.
Wonderful. Such a wonderful suggestion. Moms, if you believe you can be a trendsetter, go ahead and type in the comment box, I can be a trendsetter. Because, you know, all of us go through different phases in life. But the faster we come out, the faster we decide to own our strength, and the faster we start living our life to the full potential, unknowingly, there are a lot of people who will follow us, and we can be a guiding light to people. They may not come and tell you, but the way you lead lives could be an inspiration for many people. Wow, sir, thank you so much for giving that powerful message. Now, coming back to the subject, you know, as mothers, we have like, you know, most of the time we carry kids, right? Kids are always like testing a mom's superhuman powers. And we realize we are not superheroes, but we tend to try to become superheroes and we end up getting hurt. Especially when we are raising kids, we have a habit of carrying the child on the hip on one side, you know. A lot of mothers, when the kid is crying or cranky, what we do is we jut our hip out to one direction. We carry our kid and do our day-to-day activities. Because of us, there is small deviation which happens in hip. Sir, do you have any suggestions for mothers like that?
Yes, so that has been studied by World Spine Association. The way we carry, nobody on the earth carry the way we carry, the Indians carry. That's the reason that they have come out with a front back where you can keep the child, you know, opposite to each other. And that will transmit the weight in the spine. And that will not be any stress on one side of the spine. So you will not develop anything. Okay, first to 6 months, 7 months is okay. But once the child started, you know, sitting, crawling, walking, always I advise you to put the baby in the, you know, that bag, which will keep, you know, opposite each other. That will distribute the weight in a uniform manner to entire spine. So that will not hurt you.
Right. Instead of carrying the child on one hip, it is always advised to take the baby in a baby carrier. And you can carry about doing your work in a normal manner.
Yes.
It's not suggested to hold the baby only.
You can walk even up to kilometers. There is no problem at all.
Hmm. So baby carrier either in the front or in the back?
Yes. I personally feel initially first 1 year, 2 years, front is better. They'll be more comfortable. Hmm. And at the same time, baby can be fed. While traveling, also she can be fed.
Absolutely, absolutely. Sir, another question which most often mothers go through is, you know, like tailbone pain. Post-pregnancy, they have lower back pain, especially in the tailbone area. It's called as tailbone terror. They can't even sit properly. So,
I know what it is. This is what we call the tip of the spine is called coccyx. The coccydynia, they call. See, what happened when they were carrying, they accumulated a lot of water and fat or something like that. After delivery, the fat as well as the water recede from there. The bone becomes subcutaneous. So all these months, you know, they were comfortable in sitting and all. They were sitting on a fat pad so that it won't be like this. So what happened when the fat disappears, I mean like disintegrates from there, the bone is the subcutaneous, that is underneath the skin. When they sit on the hard surface, they find this problem. Many women complain that. What I personally feel that they should always sit on the soft surface. Mm. And if they have more pain, they can use a cushion, you know, like a tube.
Right.
So see that area is hanged in the air. That will not come in contact with the, you know, ground.
Right.
I advise no painkillers because they must feed the child. I don't want any painkiller to, you know, transmit via milk.
Right.
Some people, if they cannot bear the pain, we have a procedure called radio frequency ablation. Under local anesthesia, we pass a small, very thin wire and send electric stimulation and denervate that area so that they become pain-free within 20 minutes.
Wow.
They just walk out with a smiling face.
Wow.
doctor, my pain gayab. That's what they say, doctor.
That's such a wonderful information, sir. Because a lot of mothers, they don't even observe that they are in pain. They accept the pain and they go about their daily chores. I personally feel there is a solution for every pain that mother is undergoing. And in the early stages, if we can address, it will not lead to later on problems, which yes. can cause deformity of the entire skeletal structure.
Yeah. Yeah, I will tell you two things. I want to, okay, of course you're telling, but I want to be very categorically statement that unfortunately, we are working hard, but we are not doing the physical exercises, which will keep us this. Working hard is different from physical exercises. Those are the different way of work hard, which keeps us fit. We work hard 18 hours, but we are not working in a proper manner. That is the problem with us and with the Western people. Western people, they work hard, they do physical exercises during the pregnancy, after the pregnancy. Especially in the Telugu states, once a girl, a woman becomes pregnant, they overfeed her, they don't allow her to work. That is even at least 80 to 90% of the people are doing the same mistake. I call it as a mistake. Why I am using the word, people should realize at least now, at this era. Because you are not doing, 10% of the people, yes, they are going to the work up to the last day of the delivery. Or, you know, they are, you know, working at home, they are working like that. They go to school to pick up their first child or second child like that. Because you are not doing any work, you know, work, and you are lying down in the bed only, taking rest. Sometimes even gynecologists are misleading the girls. No, don't, because you are very delicate. If you walk, or you may abort, like that.
Right.
Some odd feelings are, you know, injected into their minds. So the right. parents as well as the girl, lady, the pregnant woman, they get frightened. Oh, doctor told me so, I should not do work. And rest. I'll tell you one more thing. If any doctor says that you take rest, that doctor is a god to them. But
Absolutely.
That is not the truth. That is not true. I personally feel that the more you work hard, the more you fit, and the easy the delivery, and the faster the recovery. That's what I always say that.
Absolutely. So,
yes. I always tell all the women who are about to deliver, who are pregnant, who would continue in the future, you please have a balanced diet, work normally till the last minute, and try to take rest as and when necessary only. Don't take rest for rest, you know, take only rest if it is necessary, otherwise no. And do the exercises properly, fitness exercises, because now so many exercises are available for a pregnant on the online, or you know, so many people are, you know, now communities have started this orientation program for women, especially pregnant women, and post delivery. Here, especially in the Telugu states, after delivery also, for 6 months, 9 months, they have overfeed the lactating mother. This only misconception. No, you have to give the milk to the baby. You should not eat for one, you should eat for two. That is a misconception. The people are putting on a lot of weight. Putting on weight is very easy. Losing weight is very, very difficult. And whereas in Western society, I have seen, where I work in England and all, the third day, they start going to work. You don't believe, I'm not exaggerating this.
Absolutely. I agree, sir, because even I went to work on the first day after giving birth. I took my son and I went to my clinic.
Yes. Why I tell you, the moment you start working, your skeletal system become, you know, toned up, and your muscles are, you know, muscles toned up, and your circulation improves. And because you are moving, your calcium is distributed equally, and you are mentally alert. Once you start taking rest, what happens? Your all systems become lethargic. You put on weight, and psychologically also you are little depressed. I tell all the women who are all at the Zoom meet now, please motivate, encourage all the women who are, you know, conceived or about to deliver or post deliver. Let them work hard. Let them do physical exercises. And start the pelvic exercises, everything after the, they develop the pelvic floor exercises.
Right.
That will strengthen their, you know, pelvic muscles and all, so they don't sag down.
Right. Right. So mothers, on Tuesday, 8 p.m., I'm getting a pelvic floor specialist on our live. This whole week, we're going to do lives with experts, especially around pregnancy and motherhood and how we can overcome the generic problems over here. On Tuesday, 8 p.m., do log in on the Million Moms channel. We're getting a pelvic floor expert. She's amazing. You'll be amazed with what she's going to talk. And today we are having Dr. Dasharath Ram Reddy Garu. He's an orthopedic surgeon and he's a trauma specialist. Sir, another major challenge when the women start exercising suddenly, you know, they have put on weight post-pregnancy, yeah. They've not done anything. And after 6 months, they realize they have to do something, they start exercising. And when they do squats, they start having knee pain.
Yeah.
So they stop immediately. They go to a doctor and they stop exercising altogether. So what is your advice as an orthopedic surgeon? How can people overcome this knee pain when they're overweight?
Yes, sir. Knee pain is a symptom that your knee is getting wear and tear. Majority of time, very minute time you have the ligament pain or something, first of all, you should not sit in the sofa. That is the, one of the main reasons you have the, what do you call that, knee pain. Second one, you should not squat. Third one is you should not sit cross leg. And avoid steps. These are the four things you have to do. And from the day one, you have to do knee strengthening exercises. That will relieve you from the pain. If somebody is having the knee pain, first of all, they have to see whether did they hurt the knee or did they put on weight or did they overstretching or are they sitting in the, you know, especially when the child is born, they try to sit on the ground to make the baby, you know, the washing and all, you know, that they take bath and all, they do things. That time also, because the pregnancy always puts some weight on women, the weight will cause strain on the knee joint when you sit in the cross leg. So these are the reasons. So try to gain the weight that is required, not more than that. And the focus should be, you should give equal importance for your weight reduction the way you take care of the child, newborn. Equally important. It is not the child that is the only thing important in your life. Your well-being also is as important as your child. I tell everybody, don't concentrate on only your child. They will come out. Even you concentrate, you don't concentrate, you do. You concentrate as per the required concentration, not beyond that. Let them not be dependent on you. Let them be, you know, independent on their own from the childhood. Now, the world is changed. You just cannot, you know, make them dependent on you. Okay, you have your own life. You have your own, way of living. You have your own time. You have to dedicate for yourself to keep you fit.
Wonderful, sir. That's such a powerful advice. Because most of the mothers, they make the child their whole life. And they end up in severe problems. Especially, I've seen mothers... They start behaving like a 50 or 60 year old only in their 30s. And it's very, very scary to see that. Because imagine they age 30 years earlier than required. And the moment they get them, they stop moving. Instead of addressing that pain, instead of getting that knee pain corrected, what they do is they stop exercising because they think exercise is the problem.
Yeah, that's what. Unfortunately, even now, many women think that. They just born to produce the children. I'm sorry, but this is it. I am making this comment to tell them you are not for that. It is a... Hello?
Yeah, sir. Go ahead.
Yeah.
It's a part of your life.
No, part of your life, that's all. It is a natural process. That is not the only thing in your life.
Hmm.
The entire, it's a biological system. That's all I say that. You have so many things to do that, especially the coming time, the post-corona, we have more responsibilities. Having the child, bringing up the child is the part of your life, that's all. That is not the only thing you have in your life. You have so many things to do that. and you have child in the right time, don't have child in the wrong time. Why I'm telling you, before, my sister and all, they used to have child at the age of 20 years. Now, people are having 30, 27 years, 30 years. And I see some, especially work women, they're having the child at 35 years. Of course, they say that, sir, we want to settle in our life and then only we want to have a child. But you agree, but nature doesn't agree. Having child after 35 years, they have some medical problems, you know, emotional problems, these things and all. I advise, it's only my sincere advice, you finish your, you know, giving birth to a child by 30 years so that you will have ample time to enjoy their, you know, bringing up them like that. At the age of 35, right, the hormonal imbalance, especially mothers who are delivering after 35 years, they are developing some psychological problem because they are not able to cope up. The distance is, right, the gap is so much between the mother and the child. The thought process is not matching. So there will be some psychological disturbances. This is what the British Medical Journal, you know, Journal was telling about this. This is what I read. I am just passing on to you so that all wonderful moms would follow this.
Wonderful, sir. Sir, a very, very powerful word that you have said. It's like really inspiring. Having a child is a part of your life, but that is not your entire life. You have an independent life of your own. Don't make it dependent on you. You lead an independent life. This is what is a very, very powerful message that you have said today, sir. Because surprisingly, in this generation, though they're very educated, they have lost this most important learning. I don't know where it has got lost. Who has put this in our minds? I really don't understand. But only one or two kids, they make them their entire life. You forget that they are individuals. They have a life beyond kids. And they are completely, they become like servers for the kids and the whole family.
Yes, yes, yes. That's what I feel very, I pity. I said that, no, you have to. Few things I oppose the Western world, few things you have to inherit from them. I'm telling you, they look life with a practical attitude. Their emotions are less, we have more emotions. We have to balance those emotions. The problem is, our life is governed by our emotions. It should not be like that. You have to have a practical thing. That's what I personally feel that. Let the emotional should not take you for a ride. That's what I say that. You give importance. Yeah, you give importance. You balance emotions, everything. Then only you can deliver a balanced outcome to your child.
Wonderful. Thank you so much, sir. It's real pleasure having you and hearing from a wise person like you. The practical aspects of life, you have traveled the world, you have seen best of both worlds. Not just that, you treat multiple patients and that too from traumatic situations, you get them back to life. To hear from you and to have you with us on Million Moms talking such powerful words of wisdom is an inspiration to a lot of mothers here. A lot of mothers have posted. I'm just going to read out their comments that they are posting over here. Wish we have known this before itself. Shravya, she's saying, wish we would have known this before itself. Anusha is saying, wonderful words, sir, amazing advice. Shrilakshmi is saying, because of the societal conformities, we have succumbed to all of this. But listening to you, it's an inspiration. And even Prasanna is saying, very, very nice words, sir. I think they are beginning their Mother's Day with a bang. Thanks to having you on with us. Sir, in closing, do you want to say anything powerful? And if people want to reach out to you with any knee pain, any back pain, anything, well, how can they reach out to you if you can say
yeah,
that?
You note down my secretary's number, Lakshmi, 99499999. I work round the clock, Yashoda Hospital, Swamaji Guda, Rajbhavan Road. Room number 338. Monday to Saturday, morning 9 to 3, evening 6 to 9. I am available. Okay? I wish none of my, you know, the viewers need me as a doctor, but I am there at their service. I wish they don't need me as a doctor, but I am at their service all the time. thank you very much. You have given me a wonderful opportunity to meet all these wonderful mothers on this an auspicious day. I wish every one of you the very best the coming year.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for being with us.
Yeah. Thank you. Bye.
Bye.